Hello, my dear students. I am Pratibha Deya from the English Lux. Let's look at the line-by-line explanation of the chapter, The Sound of Music, Part 1, written by Deborah Cowley of Class 9th, Beehive Book. If you are watching my videos for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanation of lessons from classes 9th to 12th English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. Outline of our video is detailed summary, moral. Let's start. Introduction. Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. Evelyn Glennie listens to sound but without hearing it. How it's possible? Let's discuss the title. The title itself is very interesting. Here the author says Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. Now we all wonder, we are confused. How can you listen to sound when you can't hear? So this is something we will discover, that how Evelyn Glennie was able to learn to sound although she could not hear. Evelyn Glennie was a determined and hard-working girl. With her rock strong willpower, she overcame the obstacle that was presented by nature. In childhood, she lost her hearing capabilities gradually. At the age of 11 years, her hearing power was severely damaged. Now, before we proceed with the chapter, let's discuss. God may have taken her hearing, but He has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Someone has commented this about Evelyn. He says that although God took away her hearing power, she was impaired, but He gave her an extraordinary thing, and that was the sense of feeling. She could feel very deeply, far more deeply than any of normal people. And that is why she was able to express music so beautifully, so well. She is a well-known multi-percussionist. She plays different percussion instruments like xylophone, drums, etc. Let's start the chapter. Rush for hours, crowds, Joshal for position on the underground train platform. A slight girl, looking younger than her 17 years, was nervous yet excited as she felt the vibrations of the approaching train. The scene is of the train platform. It is underground and there is a huge rush at the platform. People were pushing each other to get way. There is a small thin girl. It is Evelyn. Evelyn is standing at the railway platform waiting for the train, and just as she feels the vibrations of the approaching train, she realizes that the train is about to come. She gets nervous and excited. This is the train that will take Evelyn to London. She is going to London to learn music as she has got admission in the Royal Academy of Music. Right now, Evelyn is in Scotland. Evelyn belongs to Scotland. Scotland is a country in Europe. Life in Scotland is not as fast as in London. London has a very fast life. It is urban, whereas Scotland has farms and countryside. So that is why Evelyn is nervous, because she is leaving Scotland for London. And she is excited also because she is doing something that she always dreamt of. She is going to the Royal Academy of Music to learn music. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. Daunting, frightening, scary. Teenager, a person who is in his teens. Evelyn is 17 years of age. She is a teenager and she is fresh from a Scottish farm. As Evelyn is from Scotland, which has more of farms and countryside, so She has not seen fast life. That is why she is nervous. And the writer says that she is fresh from a Scottish farm. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf. Aspiring musician, a person who wants to be a musician. Profoundly deaf means absolutely deaf. Evelyn could not hear, and this was a bigger challenge for her. Moving from a rural area to a fast life was a smaller challenge. Evelyn faced a much bigger challenge, that was her inability to hear. Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual in phases. Slowly she started losing the power of hearing, and one day she was absolutely deaf. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. They called her name and she did not move. I suddenly realized she hadn't heard, says Isabel Glennie. Isabel Glennie is the name of Evelyn's mother. She recollects one incident when Evelyn was 8 years old. She says that Evelyn was waiting for her turn to play the piano, but when her name was called out, she did not respond, and her mother realized that she did not hear her name being called out. For quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from friends and teachers, conceal to hide. As Evelyn lost her sense of hearing in phases, it was a gradual process. In the beginning, when she could hear partially, she managed to hide this disability from her friends and teachers. But by the time she was 11, her marks had deteriorated and her headmistress asked her parents to take her to a specialist. Specialist, a doctor specializing in a particular part of the body. Deteriorated, reduces, asked, requested. When Evelyn was 11 years old, her marks had started deteriorating. The headmistress requested her parents to take Evelyn to the doctor. It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nerve damage. When the doctor checked upon Evelyn, he found out that Evelyn had lost the sense of hearing. They were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aids and sent to a school for the deaf. The doctor advised Evelyn's parents that they should get hearing aids for her. Hearing aids is an equipment that is fitted into your ear and it helps a person to hear. He also suggested that Evelyn should be sent to school for the deaf children. Everything suddenly looked black, says Evelyn. When Evelyn discovered that she could not hear and that she would be sent to a school for deaf children, that she was not as good as normal children, her world became colorless. It turned black. What does this mean? Everything suddenly looked black. It means that all of a sudden you get such bad news that you don't expect, and in return you see blackness all around you. That is how Evelyn responded to this news. But Evelyn was not going to give up. This shows Evelyn had determination. Although Evelyn got such a shocking news, still she was determined and she did not want to give up. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music, pursue to follow. As Evelyn was passionate about music, this news also did not break her. She was determined to live life like normal people and follow her interest in music. One day she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it too. Xylophone, a musical instrument with a row of wooden bars of different lengths. When Evelyn saw a girl playing the xylophone, she wanted to play it too. Most of the teachers discouraged her, but percussionist Ron Forbes spotted her potential. Percussionist, a person who plays the drum, the tabla, etc. potential, ability that can be developed. Now, on one hand, Evelyn's teacher discouraged her because they knew that she could not hear, and hearing was an important part of music. But Ron Forbes saw that Evelyn was very passionate about music, and so he decided something. He began to tuning two large drums to different notes. Ron Forbes thought an idea that he would teach Evelyn to feel music. He took two large drums and he tuned them to different notes. Drums are musical instrument, and he tuned them. He tuned each drum to different notes, so the sound produced by the drums was different. So it was distinct. Both the drums made different sounds. Then he told Evelyn, "Don't listen through your ears," he would say. "Try to sense it some other way." Ron Forbes said that, "Don't try to listen through your ears." He said that, "Try to sense it. Try to feel the music some other way." Says Evelyn, "Suddenly, I realized I could feel the higher drum from the waist up and the lower one from the waist down. The middle of your body is called the waist." Now Ron had tuned both the drums to different notes. The upper part of Evelyn's body above the waist could feel the higher notes of the drum, and the lower part of her body, the part down from the waist, could feel the lower notes of the drum. Forbes repeated the exercise, and soon Evelyn discovered that she could sense certain notes in different parts of her body. This is how Evelyn can listen to sound. Although she cannot hear, she can sense different notes in different parts of the body.
I had learned to open my mind and body to sounds and vibrations. The rest was sheer determination and hard work. Ron Forbes taught Evelyn to respond to different sounds. Different parts of Evelyn's body responded to different sounds, and that is how she could identify the sounds and the different vibrations. Now, once she could identify the sounds and vibrations, the hurdle had been overcome and Evelyn's career went upwards, as she had determination of becoming famous, a good musician, and she also did a lot of hard work. She never looked back from the point onwards. Once Evelyn overcame the hurdle, she started sensing the different sounds through the different parts of her body. She progressed in her career. She toured the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra, and by the time she was 16, she had decided to make music her life. Youth, young people, people like who are in college or high school, orchestra, group of musicians. So Evelyn toured the United Kingdom and performed with a youth orchestra. By the time Evelyn reached the age of 16 years, she had decided to make music her life. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the Academy. Evelyn gave an audition for the admission to the Royal Academy of Music, and her score was the highest in the history of the Academy. No other person had scored such a high score as Evelyn did. She gradually moved from orchestral work to solo performances. Orchestral work means group performances, performing in a group of musicians. Solo, to perform single or alone. So initially, Evelyn performed in a group, and as she got well in her music, as she got confident, she started performing alone. At the end of her 3-year course, she had captured most of the top awards. She had achieved all the top awards by the time she had completed her 3-year course at the Royal Academy of Music. And for all this, Evelyn won't accept any hint of heroic achievement. If anyone says that Evelyn has done something great, she does not acknowledge that. She is very humble and down to earth. If you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. Evelyn says that two important things for success are firstly hard work and secondly aim. She says that if you work hard and you have an aim, a target which you have to achieve, then you will definitely achieve it. And she got right to the top, the world's most sought after multi-percussionist with a mastery of some 1,000 instruments and hectic international schedule. Most sought after means most popular, in demand. So Evelyn also achieved her goal. She worked hard and she had an aim to become the topmost, the most famous, the most sought after musician of the world. And she did that. She gained mastery of almost 1,000 musical instruments and she is the most popular multi-percussionist of the world. She has a very busy schedule. She has programs and concerts all over the world. It is intriguing to watch Evelyn function so effortlessly without hearing. When you watch Evelyn work or perform so effortlessly, although she can hear, you get very curious because Evelyn can identify the slightest, the minutest sound made by the musical instruments. In our two, our discussion, she never missed a word. Now the writer Deborah Cowley took Evelyn's interview, which lasted for 2 hours, and Deborah says that Evelyn never missed a single word that she spoke. Man with bushy beard gives me trouble, she laughed. Evelyn says that those men who have long, huge, bushy beard give her trouble. Why do they give her trouble? Do you know something? Because when they speak, she cannot see their lip movement or their lips are covered with the bushy beard. It is not just watching the lips. It's the whole face, especially the eyes. Evelyn says that she does not only see the lip movement of the person's face to make out what the person is speaking. She sees the whole face, that means the entire expression of the face of the speaker makes Evelyn identify or know what the person is saying. She says the expression of the eyes helps Evelyn make out what the person sitting in front of her is saying. She speaks flawlessly with a Scottish lilt. The writer says that Evelyn's speech is flawless and she has a Scottish accent. My speech is clear because I could hear till I was 11, she says. Evelyn says that she can speak clearly because she had learned the language she studied till the age of 11, till the time she could hear. But that doesn't explain how she managed to learn French and master basic Japanese. But after becoming deaf, Evelyn also learned two new languages. She has learned French and basic Japanese. So one wonders that how could she learn these two new languages also despite her deafness. As for music, she explains, it pours in through every part of my body. It tingles in the skin, my cheekbones, and even in my hair. Tingles means causes a slight prickling or stinging sensation. So here Evelyn explained that how does she identify music? It creates sensation in her skin, in her cheekbones, and even in her hair. So every part of Evelyn's body respond to music. When she plays the xylophone, she can sense the sound passing up the stick into her fingertips. When she plays the xylophone, she uses sticks and she can sense the vibrations of the sound produced by the xylophone pass through the sticks up into her fingertips. By leaning against the drums, she can feel the resonances flowing into her body. Resonances means echoes of sounds. When Evelyn plays the drum, she leans towards the drum and she can feel the echo flowing into her body. On a wooden platform, she removes her shoes so that the vibrations pass through her bare feet and up her legs. Whenever Evelyn performs, she performs on a wooden platform, and she removes her shoes so that she can feel the vibrations of the musical instruments pass through the floor into her feet and up her legs. That is how she can feel the sound of the musical instruments. Not surprisingly, Evelyn delights her audiences. In 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award. Now, Evelyn is a delight to hear. She gives very good solo performances. In the year 1991, she was presented with this award, Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award, for performing solo. Says master percussionist James Blades, God may have taken her hearing, but he has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Now, James Blades is a master percussionist, and his words were the ones that we read before we started reading the chapter. According to James, God took away Evelyn's hearing ability, but in return, he gave her a strong power of sensing words, which enabled her to become a great musician. Evelyn confesses that she is something of a workaholic, means a person who finds it difficult to stop working. Evelyn is very hard working. She does not stop working. I have just got to work, often harder than classical musicians. Now, to be at par with those people who can hear, who are classical musicians, Evelyn works very hard. But the rewards are enormous. Meaning of enormous is big. Evelyn says that the rewards she gets for her hard work are huge and big. Apart from the regular concerts, Evelyn also gives free concerts in prisons and hospitals. Evelyn does charity also. She gives free concerts in hospitals and prisons. She also gives high priority to classes for young musicians. She also takes classes for young musicians for those children who want to learn music. Next is, Anne Richlin of the Beethoven Fund for Deaf Children says, she is a shining inspiration for deaf children. They see that there is nowhere that they cannot go. Evelyn is an inspiration for all. She is an idol. Anne Richlin, who belongs to the Beethoven Fund for Deaf Children, says that Evelyn is an inspiration for those children who cannot hear. And when they get to know Evelyn's story, they feel that they can accomplish everything, they can fulfill all their dreams. Evelyn Glennie has already accomplished more than most people twice her age. Accomplished means achieved. Evelyn Glennie has achieved so much in life that those people who are double her age have also not achieved those many things, that much popularity and those many awards as Evelyn has done. Evelyn has brought percussion to the front of the orchestra and demonstrated that it can be very moving. Orchestra is a group of people who are playing different musical instruments, and generally the percussion instruments like the drums and the xylophone are placed at the back end of the orchestra, or they are placed at the side, but as Evelyn performs solo, she gives special performances with these percussion instruments, and the percussion instruments have come in front of the orchestra. She has given inspiration to those who are handicapped people, who look at her and say, if she can do it, I can. And not the least, she has given enormous pleasure to millions. Evelyn's story is an inspiration to those people who are physically disabled. They feel that if Evelyn can achieve her dreams, even they can. And Evelyn has given a lot of pleasure to her audience by playing such good music. Moral of the story is that there are so many obstacles in our life. We have to face them with possibilities like Evelyn Glennie. She was deaf from the age of 11. But she don't fail in life. She listen music from the vibration of body. It is based on the theme that determination, sincere efforts and able guidance are the way to success. She overcame the challenge of her impaired hearing through her firm belief in herself and great confidence in her life. Thank you for watching this video. Do like, share and comment your views and let me know if you have any kind of confusion. Thank you.
Make sure if you have any suggestion and comments, feel free to write in the comment section. And for more videos, like and subscribe my channel, The English Lux, your key to English. And don't forget to hit the bell icon.